Hello, welcome to episode 50, believe it or not, of Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. This game is turning out to be a lot longer than I thought it would be. Having a great time, though. Let's see if we can do anything to further disguise Gulliver into scaring the shopkeeper into possibly giving us his instrument?
Every time I talk to him.
Okay, well. Let's see, maybe some bloody rags would help? No? What kind of fishing rod? Tie Gulliver to the fishing rod.
I've come up with an idea on how we can get you to fly.
I'm glad you did.
Really?
Yes. I don't want to go into detail, but let's just say there's something to do with this homemade fishing rod.
I see. Tie it up.
Cool. Let's go. Time to do some haunting.
What do you think, Gulliver? Is it time to give the mare a bit of a fright?
We can at least give it a go.
This is going to be extremely interesting.
Flying ghost this time. Oh, very nice.
Take the sheet off. He'll be scared.
He doesn't look very more scary. But he can speak. Whoa. Oh, nice effect. But I've already seen ventriloquists at the fun fair.
But...
gotta take the sheet off.
He'll be back. Ooh. Let's get out of here.
But everything usually startles him.
He didn't seem scared this time.
Nope.
Don't let your head drop. We'll think of something and try again.
Then we'll just have to make the costume even spookier.
With the bloody rags.
Gulliver.
Yes?
Should we give it another try?
No, it won't work. We have to be scarier.
Scarier than that? Right then. Hold the fort.
We're here if you need us.
Now with the bloody rags? No. I'm gonna hold an axe? No. Sand? You still use the glowing coal?
Oliver. I'm just thinking, if we could get our ghosts to glow using a couple of hot pieces of coal.
Or how about glowing eyes? That would be even scarier.
Right.
Great idea. Then all we need is some kind of holder for them. And we need to be very careful. Those coals are very hot.
Oh, right.
Maybe Nate can help.
Here, hold these. Don't lose them.
Yeah.
Oh, we got eyes.
Nate, give me two pieces of coal. Red glowing ones from down at the bottom, if possible.
Your loot.
And? How do I look?
That is really spooky. And also just a touch revolting.
That's how it should be.
Gulliver.
Yes?
Time to do some haunting.
This time we'll do it.
Let's spook!
Thing is, a zombie head is probably scarier than the ghost sheet.
Ooh, wow! Wow! Oh, that looks really scary. Well done.
Aha! Then you should use your PKE and see what it says.
Oh, I don't need it. I know there's nothing supernatural at work here.
How do you know that?
Well, for one, I can see the string you're using to hold up the ball of whatever it is.
Show him the head.
And I can see you. I'm even speaking to you.
Okay. I'll give you that one.
Wilbur? But the eyes look great. And the voice is good too. How do you manage to make it sound as if it came from the ghost?
Why do I smell burning?
That voice isn't coming from me. It's coming from...
Fire! Fire! Oh,
Reveal the head. Here we go.
Ow! What the devil is going on here? Where is everyone? What is that?
The rubber ball has changed itself into an evil skull.
The... Right. I'm an evil, terrible, demonic skull. Fear me.
But I'm not getting any sign of supernatural activity.
That's because us evil demons have learned how to haunt without being recognized.
See, the PK is useless. Just give it to us.
That's not possible.
But there's more. Get the man with the PKE, the Heart of the Woods said.
Ha.
No.
We shall return.
He says, bouncing with the PKE in his mouth.
Unexpected.
We're doomed.
We're doomed.
No, I'll find the Heart of the Wood and put an end to this. Have no fear. See? See you later.
Googly eyes.
Those are Gulliver's eyes. Well, they are now. I don't know who they belonged to before that. One of them is green, the other one brown. And both look unimpressed. I don't think they like the fact that I've been carrying them around in my bag.
Chop them up. Put sand in their eyes. Put them in a mug. Put them in that. Or pierce them with this. Anything else to say to him?
Everything okay?
I thought it was just another of your jokes. But you see what this place can do to simple jokes.
I didn't mean to scare you. Oh, no, well, actually I did. But not like that. I'll make it up to you. I'll find the Heart of the Wood and defeat our enemy.
Let's hope it's not too late. You heard what the demon said? Him and his band are coming back to get me.
You'll be okay. They wanted to get the man with the PKE and you don't have it anymore.
I hope so. I really do.
Probably a weird thing that is what happens with the voice. I kind of like it though, it's pretty neat.
So, Wilbur, well, how'd you think we did?
Smashing.
From what I saw up there, he almost wet himself.
Right.
That would have made me feel even more guilty. I wish we didn't have to scare him that badly.
Yeah, well.
All for a good cause. If you can track the Heart of the Wood with the PKE and destroy it, then you'll actually be helping him. Here, catch.
If I use it in the woods, it'll show me the way to the Heart of the Woods. But first, I'll need something to defend myself against werewolves.
Then go to it.
Every time I talk to him, Nate has tried time and time. I think Nate has been put in a few... And it...
Right. Okay. I guess I can enter the woods right from here.
The sorcerer Van Buren spent... He didn't trust his brother. As soon as we've rescued Timmy and Esther...
Alright, let's take a look at this thing. That's what PKE stands for. Psychokinetic Energy Meter.
A solid piece of gnome engineering.
Oh, it is gnome engineering.
As soon as one gets close to something supernatural, the arms on the sides of the device lift up. We should be able to use it to find the Heart of the Wood.
It's directly from Ghostbusters.
Hey, haven't you forgotten something?
What?
What? My eyes.
Oh.
Oh, sorry.
Your catch. Take the coals out first.
Some of my best ones.
Esther says the left one is the most handsome one I have.
Every time I talk...
All right. Examine him with the PKE.
As expected, nothing. Luckily, the mayor thought a living flaming skull was something supernatural. Gulliver's just your normal run-of-the-mill zombie.
About neat. I know nothing, but...
Perhaps modern technology sometimes feels like magic to some people. But it's more the opposite. That's why the PKE is not reacting.
Hmm. Okay. So, how do I find my way with this? Figure it illuminate the path for me or something like that? Oh, a stone head.
You can find these stone heads all over Aventasia. They're ancient and no one knows who made them.
Hmm. I can't use it on that? Okay. I'm gonna get lost in here because I'm not writing anything down. Huh? Are you back behind there, bounty hunter?
Something in the undergrowth here. Something big.
Esther?
I can't see what it is. It could be Esther. But it could just as easily be a werewolf or some other monster of the woods.
Oh, I can't do PKE on this thing.
I can't just stand in front of a bush and push the branches apart. What if there's a werewolf in there ready to attack?
Well, I wanted to use the PKE, but nothing happened. I couldn't do it. I can't do it.
I can't see what it is. It could be Esther. But it could just as easily be a werewolf.
Okay, can I hack? Lunge at the bush with the axe.
Right then. I'll get ready for battle and...
Hello? Anyone there?
Who the hell's this?
Oh, hello, little man.
Well, hello. What are you doing here in the woods all alone and skimpily dressed?
May I ask what you're doing here? You don't exactly look like a mushroom picker.
Phew, glad to hear it. I'm on my way to my fiancé's.
My fiancé.
In the dark woods, in a magnificent castle. At least that's what he wrote. The thunderstorm took me by surprise, and then suddenly, this wrinkly old woman was standing there in the middle of the path. She pointed a bony finger at me and gave me a toothless grin. I was distracted, and my horse threw me and vanished into the woods with all my things.
That sounds terrible.
It is! I'm meeting my fiancé, and I don't have a thing to wear.
She's a ghost. She's from way back when, and she died going to find the mage, whatever. About that old woman on the path.
The old woman on the path? Sounds like she could have been a witch.
Can't wait to use the PKE on her.
She was so old and shriveled and ugly. I've never been so scared in all my life.
Another enemy to deal with.
Enemy? Are you wood pixies battling these creatures?
Wood pixies?
Excuse me, I'm a gnome, not a pixie. And I come from the mountains.
I would be very grateful never to see that face again. Hey, if you're a wood pixie and just pixying around, then... Could you find the clothes I lost? I'll pay you.
Oh, we'll see.
Not a friggin' wood pixie. Have you seen anyone else here in the woods?
I'm Wilbur. Have you by any chance seen a female zombie, a rat, a knight, a werewolf, or a headless horseman anywhere in the woods?
Can't miss them.
Oh, Lord. No, definitely not. Or more like, happily not.
You're on the way to the castle? I've got to go there, too.
Do you know the way to the castle? Could you maybe take me with you?
I don't know the way. Vladdy wrote me saying I should find a guide in the village.
Vladdy?
The way through the mountains is very dangerous.
Hmm.
Vladdy, your fiancé?
The Count.
Hmm.
So, what's he like?
Oh, he's a darling. Very rich and very old.
Very old.
I can't wait to meet him in person.
So, you're engaged to him, but you've never met him?
Why hesitate and risk someone else snapping him away from me?
I'll take you to the village. It's dangerous here in the woods.
It's too dangerous here in the woods. Come on, I'll take you to the village.
Uh-huh. Which way?
This way.
Mm.
Or, wait a minute. No.
Nah.
This way. Or, oh, bloody hell, just follow me.
Well, that was easy.
As I already said to your young friend, I won't set foot outside as long as the headless horseman is running around out here.
Then just send word to the castle asking Vladdy to pick me up from here.
How do we do that?
Oh, I wouldn't know how. I'm afraid you'll have to wait until the bounty hunter comes back with good news. Be my guest. Make yourself at home. Thank you for bringing her here. I mean, really. Thank you. Nudge, nudge, wink.
Nudge, nudge, wink, wink.
You're welcome. Hello?
Yes?
See you again sometime.
I hope so.
You don't even know her name, do we?
Hello.
Well, looky here, if it isn't my knight in shining armor and accomplished guide.
It didn't take us that long to get out of the woods.
You should try it in high heels.
Hmm. Oh boy, all kinds of stuff to say. Hmm. Have you seen this armor for female warriors?
As luck would have it, I just saw some armor for female fighters.
Yeah, I saw that too. Do you think Vladdy would like it?
No idea. It wouldn't stop a hail of arrows, I'll tell you that.
Hail of arrows? That thing isn't intended for battle.
Oh no?
You got that right. One broad axe to the leg and it'd be game over.
A lady don't go near arrows or axes. She has other spite for her. And this kind of armor would help it along a ways.
But what if a young lady really does want to fight? Doesn't she deserve a proper set of armor?
Looking good and knowing what you want. It's the only way to get ahead in life.
Is that so? Well, she's got a wolf skin. I need the wolf skin, please.
That wolf skin you have there, could you give it to me?
What? Get your own.
That's what I'm trying to do.
But I need it. No, actually, I need 10.
Cut them up into 10 pieces.
I'm supposed to freeze just because you need a fur?
Absolutely.
That wolf skin.
What?
But I...
But...
I could offer you this blanket in return for the wolf skin.
If you're cold, I'd be happy to give you this nice warm wool blanket.
Thank you, but this fur is just fine.
Yes, but...
But I need that fur.
But I need that fur. Please. And this blanket will keep you just as warm.
Oh, but it isn't very fluffy and cozy, is it?
Well, you see, it's like this.
I don't know if the fur suits you.
Don't you think that fur looks a little, you know, strange.
What do you mean?
Well, it's just... Oh, I don't know. It's not that chic.
But furs is so fluffy and warm, and I really don't care what those crazy animal protection people say.
Oh, it's not that. It's fashion. In Seastone, the ladies there use wool blankets. Lovely.
We need to get Petra over here.
Are you kidding? Oh, I just remembered. Vladdy, in one of his letters, once described wolves as his children of the night.
Well, in that case, you really don't want to be caught with a wolf skin, do you? And it just so happens, I have a really beautiful wool blanket on offer today.
Much better.
That's what I was saying.
So that's one wolf skin. Now where on earth am I going to get 9 more of them?
Chop them up into 9 pieces.
Hello.
What?
Chicken butt. I need silver to protect myself from the werewolf.
You don't have any silver, do you? Then I could use it to make a silver crossbow bolt to protect myself against the werewolf.
Of what interest is a werewolf in the woods to me? I want to go to the castle. That's in the other direction.
Yes, but once the werewolf is out of the way, I can take care of the headless horseman. And once he's out of the way, the mare will take us to the castle.
Maybe.
That's a bit complicated. I'd rather stage a clothing malfunction and convince the idiot to do anything for me that way. But that's risky. I wrote Vladdy that I was a virtuous virgin.
You have any silver or not?
Of course I do. I have my silver jewelry. But I'm not wasting it on your shenanigans.
If you give me some silver, I can use it to send a signal to the Count.
I think there might be a way to let the Count know that you're here.
I don't know how, though.
Oh, really?
All I need is a little silver.
For what?
I'm going to send him light signals. Morse code, you know? If I had a really, really good mirror, then the moonlight would be enough for that. And as everyone knows, nothing reflects moonlight better than silver.
Of course! You're always hearing people say, the silver moon and stuff like that.
That's right. I would melt the silver and vapor deposit it onto a piece of glass.
I love that accent. Hers.
Smart boy. So how much silver do you need?
All of it.
About the same amount as a silver crossbow bolt.
Well, if everything goes to plan, then I'll soon have coffers full of the stuff.
We need it now. Thank you.
Let me know when you're ready. It's important.
So, no luck with the mayor, huh? He didn't want to take me to the castle either.
Oh, don't take it personally. The mayor didn't want to take me up to the castle either.
Yeah, but you're you, and I'm, well, just luck.
Oh, yeah.
Why would he want to take you up to the castle more than me? I asked him very politely.
We're wasting our time. All that guy thinks about is the headless horseman and that he could be the last villager to be kidnapped. Something like that.
Something like
Some
that.
Some of us here have real problems to deal with.
I have to go. Save my friends. See you.
A hot cocoa. That'd do fine.
I don't have that.
Yeah, I better let her stew. The young lady's silver jewelry. I don't know how much it's worth. But she says she'll have more than enough very soon.
She used the PKE on her?
Nothing. No psychokinetic energy.
Okay.
I'll give it back to him when I find the heart of the wood.
I didn't want to give it to
if
him.
If everything goes to plan, then it'll just be a memento of when monsters roam the woods.
I wanted to examine him with it, but... Alright, let's... Combining random objects time. Put the silver jewelry in the stone mug, sure.
The goblet is almost full to the brim with silver jewelry. Didn't look much to begin with. The goblet is almost full.
Okay. Chop it up.
Look! A wolf skin.
You still need 9 more.
Mm. You didn't even look at it.
It was a wolf skin. You're missing 9.
Hello?
Oh, yes?
Do you really need 9 more wolf skins?
Do you really need 9 more skins? I mean, you weren't even interested in the first one.
The quest is 10 wolf skins for a light crossbow. 1 skin has been handed over, 9 are still needed. If it'll make it more fun for you, I can think up a story about why I need them.
You don't happen to sell wolf skins, do you?
Oh, sure, yes. 1 wolf skin for, 3 harpy feathers.
Ah, forget it.
Fetch quest extraordinaire.
See you again sometime.
I hope so.
All right. Is there a reason to look through the hole? Peek at the girl.
I can't see anything. The wolf skin is lying right in front of the hole.
Seriously?
Got it. It's difficult to tell one wolf skin from another, even if you look very carefully.
If this was a typical game, they would all look identical. Do we really have to do this manually, though?
I've got another wolf skin for you. Different one.
Huh.
Oh, fantastic! You just need 8 more.
But of course. Back in a minute.
That makes 10.
Nice.
So, did you gain experience while completing the quest?
Yes. Generic gathering quests are no fun at all.
Yeah. No one likes a generic collect quest.
It kills time. Isn't that the point?
Not really.
Here's your crossbow.
Ah, very nice.
Lint.
Now I finally got everything I need to go deeper into the woods. Wish me luck.
Oh, I do. And you'll need it.
Thanks.
So now I have a crossbow, and I reckon I'm halfway capable of handling it. All I need now is a silver bolt.
Well, how about we load it with the iron bolt for now?
The iron bolt is just a template. It'll be useless against a werewolf. I need a silver bolt exactly the same shape and size.
If we melt it down with the jewelry, we could do that with the fire, right?
I'm not sure what I should ask him just now. Yeah, I better let us do.
What's with this shelf?
The shelves seem to be some kind of catch-all for things. If I had more time, I'd...
Yeah. Let's see if we can make a silver crossbow bolt. Heat it up. Melt the silver in the fire.
Let's see what happens. Ah! Hot! In fact, it's hot enough to melt the silver in the goblet.
Use the molten silver with this or the sand. Huh. What if we just coat the iron crossbow with the silver? I'd like to do that.
The little fellow is... If you could...
Maybe you can help
Every
us?
Every time I talk...
Nope. Hey, he took his hat off again, and his laurel's still on. Put that on. And that on. Oh, can only have one at a time now?
Make an imprint of the bolt in the sand, but I'm carrying the sand in my pocket. The imprint will instantly fall to bits.
What can I do with the sand? What can I put it in?
The iron bolt is just a template.
What do I do? Do I need something else from the woods, maybe? Oh, that's back.
The woods are already spooky enough where I am. But over there it gets even more spine-chilling. I bet that the evil heart of the woods is somewhere over in that direction.
I thought the PKE was supposed to help us with that. Find that.
The crossbow alone isn't going to be much help against the werewolf.
Right.
I'll need a bolt made of silver before I can venture in there. So the woods weren't just the source of wood for the villagers, they also dug clay there.
Maybe we can find something here to aid us in our quest. A broken kiln?
Hard to say what destroyed the kiln, and when. Could have been time, wind and rain, but it could just as easily have been animals or other things.
Other things?
My guess is that the bricks were once fired right here in the woods. Makes complete sense. Not only is there lots of firewood here, the clay is also very moist and loses a lot of weight during firing. Why would you drag all that water into the village just to let it evaporate there?
Yeah, thinking about the stuff a lot here. Oh, the press, that's what we need.
Looks like some kind of press. If I had to guess, I'd say it was used to press clay bricks into shape. The hinge is rusted through. Forcing the press might make it break. I'd better repair it first.
Prospect?
I wonder if the villagers dug too deep and woke up some kind of ancient evil. If so, the ancient evil must have been sleeping very close to the surface.
We can get loam from here?
I should be able to loosen a really nice lump of clay just with my bare hands. Yep, no problem. By all appearances, there's been no clay dug here for years. And the rain will ensure that there won't be much to see here in a few years' time.
Squidgy lump of loam.
A nice lump of clay, perhaps a couple of pounds. Seastone pounds, that is, not brack pounds.
What's the difference? Broken press?
A wooden press used to press lumps of clay into bricks. At least that's what it was built for. Presumably, you could use it to press other things if it wasn't broken.
Press a long brick.
The hinge on the press is damaged. I'd only ruin it for good.
Press the bolt into the loam.
The bolt imprint in the clay is going to be useless like that. The clay has cracks and holes everywhere.
Hmm. Alright, let's get back then to the campfire. I'm not sure if I'm going the right way. Oh, glowing moss. Right, we never took that.
I don't know if I like luminous moss. It gives off a bit of light. That's good, but it looks a bit spooky.
Mm. Oh, we can't take it anyway? Alright. Good. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Tune back next time when we mess around with a press and loam and sand and bolts and all kinds of freaking stuff. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop that boogie.